Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da habita fillah, a question was asked, assalamu alaikum, is it allowed to boycott an Islamic speaker because he shaves the beard, although he may speak some truth? First and foremost, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and you, forgive us and you, and guide us and you. And I see that the email was also forwarded to our brother, Mufti Munir, Muhammad Munir, hafidhallahu ta'ala. And so, first and foremost, I'll say, take his advice. Go with what he says. I will offer some simple advice, and I don't think we'll probably have that far, that there will be that much of a gap in what we say. However, because of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored him with ilm, and he is of those that the people can benefit from, then I would say go to him first. But I would just offer this simple advice that first and foremost, that as you said, the person has some truth, or maybe they have a lot of truth, but you said some truth. So going on what you said, as far as boycotting, this mas'ala is a big mas'ala, or big, yeah, it's a big mas'ala, min masail al-ilm. You know, it's a big knowledge-based issue. And the bottom line is, mabni ala al-masalih wa mufasid, that it is built upon the harms and the benefits, weighing the harms and the benefits. And weighing the harms and the benefit usually comes and is more appropriately referred back to Ahl al-Ilm, you know, to the scholars or strong students of knowledge who are aware of the situation that you're referring to. So in general, as I said, it goes back to the harms and the benefit. Is there a greater benefit and it's going to change the behavior of the person or protect you from his harm by boycotting him? That's number one. And if there's a greater harm in doing so, then of course you wouldn't do it. So again, you're looking at the masalih, the maslaha, the benefits for the person making hajj, that's being made hajr from, and also your benefit and regarding the harms of the community. In general, that is definitely not the way you start and approach an issue, that you have someone in your community, maybe they're teaching you, they're offering up their time, they have this sin, they have this open sin or this open mistake or what have you. Then it would be better for you in a very humble way to approach this individual and advise them. If they accept your advice, alhamdulillah. If they don't accept your advice, you can choose not to study with them, if so. But I definitely would not advise not giving them salam, not, you know, this mas'ala, as I said, is a very serious issue. And, you know, there are so many details and details with regards to specific scenarios and situations that have to be taken in consideration. More often than not, and I found this as far as really practicing in my days as a Muslim, that more often than not, I have found mostly that there hasn't been benefit in most of the scenarios that I've witnessed of people boycotting someone. That it usually ended up just dividing, or it had no benefit at all. And more often than not, it had harm. Myself, I have, due to extreme bid'ah of some of the takfiris, have practiced that. But that is a rare scenario. The Diobandis, the Ashiris that I know, we give salams, we greet each other as Muslim brothers. They know I'm Salafi, I know they're Ashiri, and we keep it pushing. But there's zero benefit, and it would actually be a destructive thing in where I'm from if you were to try to do that. And again, the whole thing is it's a mas'ala of ibadah. It's an issue of worship. Are you drawing nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and preserving your deen by making hajr of this individual? Are you drawing nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and preserving your deen by you know, or helping this person preserve their deen. So all of these issues are issues that you want to consider, because the hajr, it's an act of ibadah. It's not something kharij ad-deen. It's not outside of the deen. It relates to the religion. This is a religious issue. So it's a very serious issue. But unfortunately, since the bab is open right now, I'm just going to mention, it has been practiced by many youth in the most wicked of ways, in the most foolish of ways, for several reasons. One is a lack of knowledge. Many of the people did not have the knowledge. Even if they went to study, they weren't rasukh, and they didn't have itqan, they weren't firm in knowledge. That's one. And number two, they didn't have wisdom, hikmah. And a lot of times, ilm and hikmah, of course, they go together. So a lot of people don't have hikmah, and they weren't aware of the masal and the mafasid. Even from the question, this guy he shortens his beard, make hajr. Just that you're thinking about hajr right off the get-go is an indication that, you know, that there's some nuks there. There's some shortcomings that you should not be rushing to jump into cutting off another Muslim. This is just not, that's not the sabil as-salaf. That's not the tariqah to salaf and how we practice that. Because the salaf, they practice these principles. And these principles come from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then how the madhab of the salaf, how they practice from the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, and the tabi'in with tabi'at tabi'in. So there's a purpose behind it, and it should be, you know, there is a purposeful intent. It's not just doing it just for the sake of doing it. This is an act of ibadah, and there should be benefit in it. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions extensively about this, and I didn't have time to go and take the aqwal, but I've talked about it in tons of the durus that are right here on YouTube. And and many of the tulab al-ilm, I'm sure, have done the same. And so there are many details that are right there in the books in English. And one of the books I will advise, because it's in English, two books that talk about this issue and give you some light about this, read Imam Abdul Mahsin well, there's only these two that are in English. Imam Abdul Mahsin al-Abad, his book, Rifq Bayna Ahl Sunnah, you know, the mercy between Ahl Sunnah. Another book is Sheikh Ibrahim Raheli's book, An-Nasiha. Regardless of what the people say, that these are immensely beneficial treatises. We don't say they're perfect. We don't say that you might not find a mistake or you might not have something you disagree with. But the bottom line is, these are immensely beneficial, and I totally recommend them and benefited tremendously, and especially in the English language, because they detail some of these issues of hajr. So I'll advise you to download it for free and go through some of the issues regarding, because he details it. So he can explain, they explain it much better than I can. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our will, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala nabiyyina Muhammad.